Hey Rachel, wanted to get you a little update of your boy. We are out doing a little walk through the park that's right behind my house. My house is just behind that pine tree. So really nice to have a good little park right by us that I can go to and work all the dogs, get them some good exposure. There's a person walking by. Oh, good boy. So, you know, typically there's lots of people, dogs here pretty often. It's a little gloomy today, so not a ton, but there's ducks, there's a little stream. Lots of good distractions here. Good, a good boy. To kind of ease him into what we like to call generalizing this obedience. And so he needs to understand, hey, this obedience happens everywhere. If I ask you to heal, it's one thing for him to do it at my house, but he's going to be able to do it anywhere. No matter where you are, no matter where you're hiking, where you're walking, no matter what dog is around, no matter what person comes up to you, he's got to stay compliant if you ask him to. So we're kind of stretching the limits of what he can do and just getting him around more and more things, just new places, not overwhelming him too much. But we're kind of starting to build some depth into all these commands. Roland, sit. Good man. Good. Sit. Oh, get that butt down. There it is. Good. And this is tough for him. There's, you know, we haven't been to this park before. There's lots of new things. It's a little bit stressful for him to... What's happening is he's relinquishing that control that he thinks he has over being able to pay attention to everything. When I say, no, you can't fixate on that. No, you can't pull me. No, you have to pay attention to me only. That's really hard mentally. And now I'm saying, basically, you know, if there's things in the world that are freaking you out a little bit or very interesting to you, you still have to pay attention to me. Okay, good boy, okay. And mentally, it's really, really hard. Like you said, like he's kind of got some ADD going on. And to ask him to focus on just one thing, when he's so used to disengaging and focusing on everything else in the world and pulling to see everything and reacting to any little thing that crosses your path, it's really hard. And so you can see a little bit of stress. He's not the most comfortable. Good, good boy. But through the stress, he gets stronger. And he'll get more and more stronger. More and more stronger. He'll get stronger and stronger every time we do this. And what it does is it builds a really good relationship of trust with me and you know, the handler. Roland, down. Down. Atta man. Down. All those elbows down. Good boy. Yeah, so it's building that trust and saying that, hey, I know there's things in the world that you want to react to, that you want to feel like he's got to control the situation. And when we say, no, you can't do that, you just pay attention to me, he's got to relinquish that control and trust that we're going to get him through that situation safely. And we kind of take that leadership role away from him. And at first, it's stressful. It's hard. He doesn't want to give up that control. We're the same way as humans. Like, got to feel like you have to control the situation. And if you feel out of control, it's a little scary. A little scary at first, but he's going to learn to trust me, whoever's holding the leash, a lot more by being able to stay in this obedience. That's a good long down, buddy. Okay, Roland. Yeah, good man. So you can see that focus is really good when he's in that down. He's holding it really well. That's some impulse control we're practicing. And again, there's not a ton going on around here. Pretty quiet little park right now. There's some people walking off in the distance, but he hardly even really notices them. But you can see these little side steps I'm taking, these little changes of direction. He's staying relatively close to me. He's staying pretty focused. Every once in a while when I turn, come on, he gets a little distracted, like right there. And we're on a bridge. He wasn't super comfortable there. So that discomfort is good because that means we can work through it and he'll get stronger because of it. So anytime he's a little bit nervous, a little bit scared, a little bit uncomfortable in a situation, we work through it by doing obedience and he learns, oh hey, that wasn't so bad. And the next time we do it, it's a lot easier. So we'll go over this bridge one more time. I think he's more concerned about like the water making noise down below him. He's not worried about the tactile surface here, but much better that time. Doesn't really matter what is setting him off, whether he gets a little bit flighty, whether he gets a little bit too interested. Roland, good boy, there we go. And that was just some more general curiosity there. Heel, good, good boy. But anyway, just working him through those scenarios, exposing him, this is what socialization is. Something scary, something different, something weird, pay attention to me. You don't have to worry about it, and it's not gonna hurt you, and you don't need to react to it, and I'm gonna get us through this situation. So anyway, really good stuff for Mr. Roland. Still building on, or working on building this focus a lot, but he's doing really, really well. I mean, he's obviously not pulling at all. He's doing really well with his e-collar. Come on. Oh, good. Come on. I know. Good man. So yeah, I'm going to go walk on this busy street, which is a little bit busier. So I'm going to put you down here, but he's doing really awesome. Let me know if you've got any questions.